Hi, everybody. This is Lacerta Ignis, a.k.a. Don Dragon on Twitch, with Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes. Tonight, we're going to be taking on the Wat Tambor special mission on the Geonosis Separatist Might territory battle. Alright, so first thing, let's take a look at my team. So, we're going to go Geonosians. So, now this is not intended to be, you know, a be-all, end-all video on the perfect setup of gear and mods for this team. I wanted to make this video to prove, actually, that it doesn't take a massive investment of time farming mods, or energy, farming relics, or even very many gear 12 pieces to be able to take this mission on. I had some difficulty taking it on with the bare minimum requirements, but I'm not that much over it now. As you can see, Toggle is still gear 11. I do have both Zetas on Brood Alpha. These are pretty important. The mod sets are pretty much just the recommended auto sets. I did a little bit of extra work on Geonosian Brood Alpha just to punch his speed up a little bit higher. And we will see, I've got him up to 256. We'll come back and we'll look at these stats quickly at the end of the video, just so you guys can compare all of those. Now, with all of that out of the way, this fight is going to be all about strategy. And that strategy starts before you even load into the battle. The first thing that you have to do is to set the proper assist order for this fight. Now, not your turn order, which is determined by your speed stats, but your assist order, which is determined by the order that you select your units as you place them into your squad. So I'm actually going to do just a little rearranging here. So, first of all, Brood Alpha is obviously going to have to be in the leader slot. After that, you're going to want Sun Fak. So whenever you do a call assist, which the Geonosians do every time they take a turn, they will actually attack in the order that you see them here. So you'll see Brood Alpha, then Sun Fak, and Geonosian Spy. Sun Fak is going to apply a buff clear to any enemy he hits, so that'll open up all the rest of your attacks. I like to do Spy second. He's not that important turn order wise or assist order wise, but I like to put him there so to make sure that he gets his crit chance up and his invisibility. Then you want to do Soldier for sure. He applies a Tenacity down, which on his basic ability, which is going to be super important because the whole basis of the strategy is going to be landing as many ability blocks with Poggle's basic ability as we can. Okay, so now that we have all that set up, got everybody in our correct turn order, let's go ahead and just jump into this. Okay, now the first thing you have to look out for. Ooh, what the heck? Whoa, that hit way harder than I was expecting. Okay, so we got to get that back. You really have to focus in on these clone sergeants pretty heavily, especially early on, because they are going to do these AoEs that are going to do a lot of damage. All right, so let's go ahead and get our tank back. That was some big early hits. That was kind of dangerous. All right, we didn't get the ability block, so we'll hit him again. All right, and now we'll switch over to this one. We've already got Tenacity down, so let's call Poggle twice just to make sure we get that ability block. Perfect. Let's go ahead and make sure. Let's just try and spread ability blocks all around. Let's see. We'll do this one. Do this one next. All right. I think that's enough ability blocking for the moment. Let's go ahead and try and clear one of these guys. Actually, let's go ahead and ability block him so he doesn't get brought back. Because if you let them get brought back, they won't have the debuffs. And so he will be able to use his ability almost immediately. And that's a problem. Alright, so now we'll go ahead and knock that one off. Really no reason to save this right now. Go ahead and pop that. got some more debuffs. He gets to attack again. We'll clear that one. All right, let's go ahead and knock... let's see. We're missing an ability block here. Let's go ahead and bat back. Oh, or we're just killing. That's fine, too. Clear that one. And we'll just keep whittling away here. Alright. They surprised me a little bit right at the start of that round. Worried me a little bit when they took out my my tank. But I think that was just a random, like, heavy crit. And everything else went pretty smooth in that first round. Alright. Now, next one you have to watch out for are these Jedi Vanguards. They have this Resolute Advance, which will do an AoE. Again, AoEs are going to do the most damage to this team because they share health. They're going to be the biggest thing you want to watch out for. He has this special thing going for him called Stalwart Defense. If he's at full health, he has 100% counter chance. Otherwise, he has 100% offense. So you really need to watch out when you get him below 100% health. You need to watch out that he does not get one of these off, because he will just shred your team. So anyway, we're going to go ahead and block him first if we can. Unfortunately, Poggle's going to be first, so he's probably not going to land this first one here. Health is good, so we're going to save this. This is going to bring some health back to your brute, which will also spread to the rest of the team. It's also a debuff clear for your team, so you really want to save that in case anything goes wrong. Let's see. Come on, let's get an ability block on this guy. There we go. That's what we were looking for. Took us a minute, though, so now we got an armor shred on this one before we could clear that. That's unfortunate. All right. Try to get hair blocked. That worked out. Might as well get him, too. Let's see. I didn't do Spy's special there because it does clear the debuffs whenever he uses it. And that would have given him an opportunity, if we didn't land the debuffs again, to possibly do an AoE on us. And I didn't want that to happen. Let's see. Let's go ahead and clear all the debuffs and put some exposes out there. Let's see. We've got block. We don't have block on this guy. Let's go ahead. Just hit him hard. All right, he's gone. Let's go ahead and block him now that one character is dead, so we don't get a revive. Even though that's probably the least threatening character that we took out first. Just kind of the way it happened there. All right, we're starting to lose a little health. I might go ahead and use Brute Alpha's special here in a minute. Yeah, we'll go ahead and do that right now. Make sure we're topped off. Nothing. Don't let anything crazy happen. Whoops. We're about to let him revive somebody. let's not do that. There we go. We got that ability block. All right, now we should have an easy finish here. Perfect. All right, on to round 3. All right. New mechanics to look out for here. Mace Windu. Let's see, which one is it? Damage against... Whoa, instantly defeats Jane. I didn't know he had that, actually. That's interesting. Okay, Mace Windu's abilities inflict Shatterpoint for 2 turns. He also deals massive damage to enemies with Shatterpoint. So once you get that Shatterpoint on there, you really want to try to clear that. If you let him... See, he doesn't do it unless he uses an ability, I don't think, though. So... but first we're going to shut down Clone Sergeant, as usual. You might have noticed I'm not using this second ability from the squadrons. That ability is really not useful here at all. The only thing it's going to do for us, because we have this extra slot filled, is clear all of their buffs. And we have enough buff clears already. Every time we attack someone, it's going to buff clear them. The second thing that's bad, actually, is if you don't have this slot empty, or if you do have the slot empty, it will actually summon the droid, and then you won't be able to summon your brute back, and your brute shares health with the rest of the team. So that can be bad. It also gives you extra call assists whenever you have him there. All right, let's try and go ahead and get that. There we go. Got the ability block. So let's go to him. Oh, let's go ahead and spread some debuffs there. There we go. Let's try to prevent this armor shred. Perfect. Okay, we're going to have to go back over here. Oh, we got to clear that. All right, we're going to use this. And you want to save this because this dispels all debuffs on your allies. But right now we have that shatter point. We want to make sure that doesn't get used against us. Let's see. All right, we didn't get the D. Let's see. No, we want to get the mark on. Ooh, both of these guys, really. But definitely this one. Okay, we got our ability block. Let's kind of try to get one on Mace now. Dang. He's just not having it. There we go. We can probably kill him. Boom. Done. All right, let's keep him from getting revived. Perfect. Another ability block. Perfect. Oh, maybe his ability basics do apply shatter point, so I might have been wrong on that. But, regardless, we're just going to work him down right now, actually. Make sure he goes down first, since he's so low. Yeah, we'll go ahead and pop that. I was tempted to save it for the next round, but we want to make sure Mace is down. There we go. Okay. Now we're sitting in pretty good shape. Ooh, if we don't let anybody get revived, that is. Okay, perfect. Now we're sitting in pretty good shape. Now we'll just slow play it out. Just use our autos. Make sure we have all of our tools off cooldown for the next round. Alright, medic's down. And clone troopers down. Perfect. Alright, final round. Okay. Now, biggest threats here. First new threat is going to be this clone arc trooper. So now he's going to have the ability to provide this entrenched status, which is going to make units harder to defeat. So we want to slow that down. He also has this huge ability that's going to daze. Daze is awful. Is absolutely awful for this team. So you have to prevent him. He's target number one. Target number two and three are going to be this Clone Sergeant and Jedi Vanguard, which we've seen before. The rest of these guys are not going to be all that important, to be honest. This guy has a call assist, but not till later in the round. But really, we're just going to focus on these three most of all. So as soon as we get that ability block on him, which we're having a little trouble with, this is getting a little concerning. Okay, got it just in time. Now we're probably going to hit, take a big OEOE. Nope, he does a basic attack. Got a little lucky. He's going to come up first, so let's go ahead and get him marked. This is not going all that well, to be honest. Okay. Okay, got our ability blocks just in time. I'm tempted to heal up just to make sure that we're in tip-top shape. Yeah, I'm definitely going to be doing that. Okay, now, like I said earlier, he's below 100% health. He's got his AoE up, so he's going to be really dangerous right now. So let's go ahead and make sure he gets marked or knocked out, one or the other. All right, we got him marked. I say marked, I mean ability blocked. Alright, we're going to heal up, just in case we have to take one of these AoEs, which we did. Oof, that's bad. But we're okay. For now. Alright. Alright, he doesn't have his AoE, so he's not as dangerous right now. So let's go ahead and try to take this guy out. Perfect. Now, he's still got his AoE, he's still got his entrench. We want to make sure that's shut down. Alright, we're going to call Poggle to assist. That means he gets to attack twice. Gives him two chances of ability blocking. He got it the first time. We'll go ahead and... I don't know why I did that, to be honest. Because he still didn't have his AoE. But that's fine. He's dead. It's perfect. You don't have to worry about him later. This guy's about to get his call assist. Let's try to kill this guy. We got him. Perfect. Alright. Start working him down. We should be clearing... free and clear at this point. So we're just going to keep working these guys down nice and steady. Make sure she doesn't heal anything. And we're on to the last enemy here. Ayla shouldn't cause much of an issue at all by herself. She's pretty much useless at this point. And Spy will finish it up. That's how it's done. And that is one Wat Tambor shard for the guild. So as you saw there, like, again... not overly geared. Mods are, you know, very mid-tier. And that went pretty smooth. Got a little bit hairy there in that last round. But really not even that close to being knocked out. And we had to try ability blocks multiple times on several of those enemies. And that's just kind of bad RNG, actually. So like I said earlier, we'll go ahead and take a look at these stats just so you guys can compare. But that's pretty much all the strategy that I have for you guys. That's, like I said, that's how it's done. Hopefully you guys can take this and apply this to your own attempts and get a few more watch shards for the guild. Thank you.